Let us pray. Our Father, we thank you for bringing us together once again for our Bible study today.
Baba wa dupe lowo yin pe e tun ko wa jopo lekan si ni asale fun eko bibeli wa.
Thank you for your love, thank you for your grace, mercy and compassion.
Adupe lowo yin fun ife yin, fun anu yin ati fun ore
yin. Thank you for the privilege of studying the word.
Adupe lowo yin fun anfani kikeko nu oro na.
We pray that you will be mightily present in our study tonight in Jesus' name.
An gbadura pe ki farahan yin ki o farahan ni ona agbara ninu ikeko wa lale ni oruko
Jesu. We pray that your spirit will teach every one of us individually. And help us to profit by the learning of your word. That our lives will become better. Our Christian lives will become enriched.
I
will become capable teachers of other people to you in Jesus' name. We thank you for the answer. In Jesus' name we pray. The Lord is leading us to continue our study of the Epistle of James. We're now in chapter 3. And we're looking at verses 1 and 2. He writes, "My brethren, be not many masters, knowing that we shall receive the greater condemnation." For in many things we offend all. If any man offend not in word, the same is a perfect man, and able also to bridle and control the whole body.
Bi enikan ko ba si sise ninu oro o na ni eni pipe oni o si le ko gbogbo ara re ni ijanu.
Our Lord Jesus Christ spoke about the tongue and the heart.
Oluwa wa Jesu Kristi o so nipa ahan ati okan.
He made us to understand that if the tree is good, the fruit will be good.
O je ki o di mimo fun wa pe ti a ba so igi di rere eso re yo di rere pelu.
He emphasized the fact that out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh.
O si tenu mo otito wi pe ninu opolopo ohun ti inu ni enu so jade.
In fact, he hinges our judgment on the final day on our words. He said, "By thy words thou shalt be justified, by thy words thou shalt be condemned."
He's telling us
then that our genuine conversion, our genuine salvation, experience of salvation is revealed by our speech, by our tongue, but what is coming out of our mouth. James also understood the importance of the tongue. In fact, he understood it so much, it appears in every chapter. In chapter 1, verse 26, "If any man among you seem to be religious and bridleth not his tongue, but deceiveth his own heart, this man's religion is vain." He's telling us that our religion, our worship is superficial if that religion does not affect our tongue.
You're
coming to chapter 2, verse 12. "So speak ye, so do you, as they that shall be judged by the law of liberty."
It's
calling upon us to know that law, the law of God, that sets our heart at liberty. Liberty to serve the Lord. And then it says, "Let that affect your speech, so speak ye." Chapter 3, he goes deep into the subject of the tongue, even so in verse 5, chapter 3, "So is the tongue, a little member, and boasted great things. Behold, how great a little a matter, a little fire kindles." In verse 6, it says the tongue is a fire. In fact, it's a world of iniquity. In chapter 4, he still talks about the tongue. He says in chapter 4, verse 11, speak not evil one of another, brethren.
Ni orikarin ese ikokanla o ni ara e ma soro ibi si ara yin.
In chapter 5 verse 12.
Ni orikarin ese ikejila.
But above all things, my brethren, swear not, neither by heaven, neither by the earth, neither by any other oath, but let your yes be yes, your yea be yea, and let your nay be nay, lest ye fall into condemnation.
O ni sugbon ju gbogbo ngogbo lo ara mi e ma se bura iba se ife orun bura tabi ile tabi ibura ki bura miran sugbon je ki be ni yin je be ni ati be ko yin je be ko ki e ma ba bo sinu ebi.
This subject of the tongue therefore must be very important to appear in every chapter of the epistle of James.
Oro lori ahan yi o lati je ko se pataki ko fi je pe ninu gbogbo epistle ti Jacob lati ri ka nbe.
And when Christ saves us, he counts our tongue very important. He saves us, he touches our heart, he transforms our tongue.
Nigbati Christi si gba wala o ka iha ti ahan wa si ohun to se pataki le lati pe le fowo to kan wa pelu.
The people who have gone into research about the lives of men and women,
awon ti won ti se iwadi nipa igbe aye okunrin ati obinrin,
they tell us that the average man speaks about 25,000 words every day.
Won so fun wa pe awon ti je okunrin wa ma soro ni nkan bi 1,600.
And the average woman will speak 30,000 words every day.
En to si je obinrin o le soro ni ona 1,600 oro lojumo.
If these researchers, they tell us that one fifth of your entire life will be taken up just talking and speaking and talking and speaking.
Awon ni wadi ti e tun so wi pe ida marun ninu ida 100 aye wa o la fin soro la fin soro la fin soro sha.
And you know, people can easily evaluate you by the kind of things you say, because your speech will give you away.
To si mo pe awon eniyan won le tete mo odi won eru eni ti o je nipa tite si si ohun ti o ntenu re jade.
That's why James is concentrating on this subject of the tongue.
Idi ni ti Jacob fi ntenu mo oro lori ahan yi.
And you will be judged by the kind of tongue you manifest.
A o si se idajo re nipa se ohun ti o nti ahan re jade.
There are 3 points we're going to examine today.
Awon ipa meta la gbe yewo loni.
Number 1, the danger of religious teachers.
Akoko o ni ewu to wa ninu awon oluko elesin.
It says in chapter 3 verse 1, my brethren, be not many masters, many teachers, many counselors, many advisers.
Tori po so ni ori kan tese ikini o ni eyin ara mi e ma se je oluko ni pupo abi eni to ngba nimoran tabi en to ndari eniyan pupo.
And then number 2, depravity revealed through the tongue.
Ekeji o ni fifi idi baje han nipa han.
If you want to know that man is a sinner, look at his speech.
So ba fe mo ipele sele nikan iwo wo oro to ntenu re
jade. Isn't that what the doctor does?
Iseke wa se nti awon doctor
se. The moment you get to the hospital and they want to know whether you are right, whether you are healthy or you are sick, they say stick out your tongue.
Nigba to ba lo ile iwosan ti o ba fe se awari boya looto laisan se o tabi o sa isan wa ni ko la han re.
And because the doctor can tell a lot about your health concerning your tongue, once he sees your tongue, he can know the spiritual condition or the physical condition of your life.
Tori pe opolopo awon nkan o ni awon dokita le so nipa pe ti o ba si oju gan ni awon re nipa se awon re won mo boya o laisan tabi o laisan.
Spiritually it is the same thing. Your tongue will reveal whether you are spiritually healthy or you are spiritually sick.
Bakan na lo si se ri nipo ti emi ahan re yo fi ohan boya o je en to nsaisan nipa temi abentara aye ra ga ga ga.
Number 2, therefore, depravity revealed through the tongue.
Nitori na koko keji nso nipa fifi idi baje han nipa han.
Number 3, declaration of our redemption through the tongue.
Eketa ijewo irapada wa nipa se ahan.
And because it's not enough I testify I'm born again, I'm saved, I'm a child of God, my name is in the book of life, my tongue will tell the story better.
Ki se pe ka kan mo fenu jalanka to pe onigbagbo ni mo ti de ni igba lati koruko mi sinu iwe iye ahan re ni o fi ru en to be.
It is your tongue that shows that you are redeemed. It is your language that shows you are a child of God. It is your tongue that gives you a way to show that you are a child of God, or maybe you are not a child of God.
Ahan re ni o si afihan iru eni to je boya ti ra o pada ahan re ni o fi ni o si afihan pe boya omo Olorun ni o tabi o ki se omo Olorun.
And let's look at number 1, the danger of religious teachers.
Eje ki awo koko akoko ewo ti o wa ninu awon oluko
elesin. We read from verse 1.
An ka lati ese ikini.
He says, my brethren, be not many masters.
O ni eyin ara mi e ma se je oluko ni pupo.
This is a special message to the church. It's talking to the family of God. It's talking to the people that are brothers and sisters. That's why he called them at the beginning of that verse, my brethren.
Ele je ise iranse ta ran si ijo ta ran si awon ara ti won ti deni igbala nu ijo idi ni to fi toka si won gege bi eyin ara mi.
This is is a verse that is almost discouraging us to rise up and rush out and begin to preach after we are born again.
Ese oro Olorun dabi ese oro Olorun eti o ma nfi iko si yan lese ti ki je keyan taratara sasa lati waasu nigba ti o ba de
nigba. Of course he knew that there are many people that will rush out without anointing, they rush out without understanding, they rush out without teaching, they rush out without the call of God. He says, wait a minute, sit down, do not be many masters, because we shall receive the greater condemnation.
Jacobu o n toka si eleyi ipe o se pataki fun wa pe ko to di pe asare jade lai si ifami royan ko to ji pa asare jade lai je pa gba iko ni to peye ko to di pa asare jade lai je pe a gbo eko ro Olorun o nilo pe ka joko ki a kokko keko ki a ka ma ba je bi nipa gbogbo ti a ba n ko
a disciple first before you become an apostle.
You're
a learner first before you become a teacher. And so he says, sit down, learn the lesson, let it do something in your life. Be not many masters, don't rush out to teach. In fact, the Bible says there are people that desire to be teachers, neither understanding what they teach or what they
are found.
They do not know the doctrine, they do not know the teaching, and they go out to teach. They will bring confusion to the hearts of the people, they will send them to hell by the false doctrine, and they, the teachers, will receive the greater condemnation.
There
are teachers that teach and their lives contradict their instruction. Their lives contradict their counseling. Their lives contradict the doctrine they are trying to teach. They will receive the greater condemnation. They are teaching right. They know what to say, but their lives contradict everything that the word of God is teaching.
That's
why the apostle is telling us here. He says, my brethren, children of God, although the zeal is there, let it not be zeal without knowledge. Don't rush out, be not many masters.
And
then he says, we shall receive the greater condemnation. Who are the we that shall receive the greater condemnation? No, not a person like Moses, who was called of God, and then the Lord said, I'll be with your mouth, I'll put the word in your mouth, not people like Moses.
He's
not talking of a person like Isaiah that the Lord said, whom shall I send and who shall go for us? And he said, here am I, send me, and the Lord gave him the word to say. He's not talking about those people.
He's
not talking about people like Jeremiah that the Lord expressly said, that the Lord told him, behold, I have touched thy mouth, I put my words in your mouth. It's not talking that Jeremiah, called of God, commissioned of God, used of God, will receive the greater condemnation. Who are the people referred to that will receive the greater condemnation? Romans chapter 2, reading from verse 20. An instructor of the foolish, a preacher, a teacher of babes, which has the form of knowledge and of the truth in the law. Thou therefore that teachest another, teachest thou not thyself? Thou that preachest that a man should not steal, dost thou steal?
Olùkọ́ àwọn aláìmòye, olùkọ́ àwọn ọmọdé, ẹni tí ó ní àfarawé ìmọ̀ àti òtítọ́ òfin ní ọwọ́, ǹjẹ́ ìwọ ti ń kọ ẹlòmíràn, ìwọ ń kọ ara rẹ, ìwọ tí ó ń wà sùkẹ́ ènìyàn kí ó má se jalè, ìwọ ń jalè.
He's talking about the people that try to teach other people. They do not apply the word to their own lives. They say don't steal and they steal. They say don't sin and they commit sin. They will receive the greater condemnation.
Ó ń sọ nípa irú àwọn olùkọ́ tó jẹ́ pé wọ́n á kọ́ àwọn ẹlòmíràn.
Acts chapter 15 verse 24. For as much as we have heard that certain which went out from us have troubled you with words, subverting your soul, saying, ye must be circumcised and keep the law, to whom we gave no such commandment.
Ti won yi yin ni okan po wi pe eyin ko gbodo sai ma ko ila ati sai ma pa ofin Mose mo eni ti awa ko fun ni ase.
Those are the people that will receive the greater condemnation. They went away from the headquarters church from Jerusalem, and they were not commissioned by the leadership in that church. They were not sent out, and then they went to subvert souls and to teach things that are wrong. They will receive the greater condemnation.
Iru awon ti won yo je biju na ni yi iru awon to je pe won jade lo lati iya ijo ni olu ijo ni Jerusalemu ti o si se pe boya awon alakoso abi awon alagba to wa nibe ni won ran won jade ti won wa bere si ni yo kan awon eniyan po iru awon eni be ni aso pe won o je biju.
Ezekiel chapter 13 verse 22.
Ninu Ezekiel ori ketala ese ikejilelogun.
Ezekiel 13:22.
Ezekiel ori ketala ese
ikejilelogun. Because with lies ye have made the heart of the righteous sad, whom I have not made sad, and strengthened the hand of the wicked, that he should not return from his wicked way by promising him life. Those are the preachers, those are the teachers that are going to receive the greater condemnation.
Nitori pe ekeni eyin fi mu okan awon lododo kaanu awon eni ti emi ko mu kaanu eyin si mu awon eniyan buburu le ki o ma ba pada kuro ni ona buburu re nipa sise ileri iye fun iru awon eni ti won yo je biju ni
These are the people that go to teach, and you know the result of their teaching. They make the righteous sad, they make the righteous unhappy, they make the righteous discouraged, and then they encourage the sinners, they encourage the backsliders, they tell them there is no problem, they say God of grace, he will pardon you, you can do anything you want and you still get to heaven. It says these people that are teaching the righteous and they are making them sad, and teaching the sinners and making them happy, they are going to receive the greater condemnation.
Àwọn tí wọ́n jẹ́ ẹlẹ́ṣẹ̀ wọ́n á mú kí wọ́n máa yọ̀ wọ́n á ní kò sí ewu lóko lóńgẹ́ torí náà kò tẹ̀síwájú nínú ìgbé ayé ẹ̀ṣẹ̀ wọn torí pé Ọlọ́run yóò ṣàánú fún wọn yóò dáríjì wọn orí ọ̀fẹ́ ní wọ́n fi gbà wọ́n là irú àwọn ẹni bẹ́ẹ̀ wọ́n ó jẹ̀bi tó pọ̀ jù.
In Jeremiah chapter 28.
Nínú Jeremiah orí kejìdínlọ́gbọ̀n.
Jeremiah had given the word of God.
Jeremiah àti fún ní ọ̀rọ̀ Ọlọ́run.
And it was the word coming directly from the mind and the heart of God.
Ó sì jẹ́ ọ̀rọ̀ tí ó ń bọ̀ tààrà látẹnu Ọlọ́run àti láti
mọ ọgbọ́n Ọlọ́run. But here came another man.
Ṣùgbọ́n ní láti rí ẹnìkan.
He didn't have the call of God.
Ẹni tí kò ní ìpè Ọlọ́run.
He didn't have commission from the Lord.
Ẹni tí kò gba ìtọ́ni Ọlọ́run.
And what he was going to teach was going to contradict the sound teaching, the biblical teaching of Jeremiah.
Ohun tí ẹni yìí sì fẹ́ kó àwọn ènìyàn ó tako ẹ̀kọ́ tó yè kóró èlé tí a ti pàṣẹ Jeremiah fún àwọn ènìyàn.
Look at Jeremiah 28 verses 15 and 16.
Ìwọ wo nínú Jeremiah orí kejìdínlọ́gbọ̀n ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹ́
Then said the prophet Jeremiah unto Ananiah, the prophet, hear now, Ananiah, the Lord has not sent thee, but thou makest the people to trust in a lie.
Nígbà náà ni Jeremiah wòlíì wí fún Ananiah wòlíì pé Bọ́ní ìsinsìnyí Ananiah, Olúwa kò rán ọ, ṣùgbọ́n ìwọ jẹ́ kí ènìyàn yìí kí ó gbẹ́kẹ̀lé èké.
That's why the apostle is saying, be not many masters.
Kí ni tí apostoli fi tẹnu mọ́ pé ẹ má ṣe jẹ́ olùkọ́ni púpọ̀?
If the Lord has not sent you out, sit down and learn and prepare for heaven yourself.
Tí Olúwa ò bá tí ì fiṣẹ́ rán ọ sáwọn ènìyàn ṣe ni kó jókòó kó kẹ́kọ̀ọ́ kó mú ara rẹ̀
sí ìjọba. The Lord has not sent you.
Ó ní Olúwa kò rán ọ.
You make these people to trust and to believe and to depend and to lean upon a lie.
O je ka awon eniyan ki won gbekele ki won fi dipa gba sinu eke.
And then in verse 16, therefore thus says the Lord, behold, I will cast thee up from the face of the earth. Do you see the greater condemnation? He was going to die prematurely. He was going to lose his life. He was going to be disfellowshipped with the Lord. And when he died that prematurely, he was not going to get to heaven. In fact, Jeremiah said in that verse 16, this year thou shalt die, because, look at it now, because thou hast taught rebellion against the Lord.
Yes, I can't deal with you. Only you are doing it.
You see, he was teaching the children of Israel to rebel against the word of God. He was not teaching them to repent. He was teaching them to rebel. He was not teaching them to be righteous. He was teaching them rebellion. And because of that, be not many masters. Don't let your teaching, don't let your doctrine teach them rebellion. Otherwise, you receive a greater condemnation. Come back to James chapter 3 verse 1. My brethren, be not many masters. Not everybody will be a pastor, be not many masters. He gave some, not all, he gave some apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, some pastors and teachers for the perfecting of the saints, for the work of God, for the development of the work of the ministry. Some will preach, some will sing, some will serve, some will pray, some will intercede. All the members of the body, they do not have the same office. And no man taketh this honor unto himself, except he that is called, as was Aaron. So then, my brethren, be not many masters, knowing that we shall receive the greater condemnation. Now let me comment on that word we. We shall receive the greater condemnation. Does that mean that James himself was counting himself as part of the people that will receive the greater condemnation? That all the apostles will receive the greater condemnation?
No.
Whenever you read the Bible, you understand the word we is what we call an editorial pronoun. That's the way we just say humankind, people in general, will receive the greater condemnation.
Look
at verse 3. Behold, we put beads in horses' mouth. It didn't mean that we apostles are riding horses, not at all. It just says we in general, we humanity, we put beads in horses' mouth. Look at verse 9. Therewith bless we God, even the Father, and therewith curse we men, which are made after the similitude of God. It doesn't mean that I'm also cursing God like all the other people are cursing God. He used the word we to represent humanity.
Ati baba o ni asifi nbu eniyan ti ada ni aworan olorun ninu gbolohun yi ko tumo si pe boya apostle Jacob nso pe o na nbu awon eniyan tabi o soro alebu si olorun sugbon o lo oro awa gege bi gbolohun ta nlo fun gbogbo eniyan.
The lesson in verse 1 is very clear.
Eko ti ako ni ese ikini se pataki.
The major instrument, the central instrument of the teacher, of the preacher, is the speech, and the agent of that speech is the tongue.
Ohun elo ele ti olu
This instrument of speech has the potential to destroy or to build up, to send people to heaven or to send them to hell.
The
individual that hurts an individual temporarily in life will be judged, will receive condemnation. How much more somebody that stands up in public and then he misleads many people and sends them to hell, he will receive the greater condemnation.
Ti gbolohun eniyan lasan ti o pa elomiran lara ni koko ati fun igba die yo ba gba idajo ninu aye yi melo melo ni a o se idajo gbolohun oluko e to si opolopo awon eniyan lona to si ran wo lo sorun egbe.
Now we go to point number 2.
An lo si koko keji bayi.
Depravity revealed through the tongue.
Fifi idiba je han nipa han.
And that's in chapter 3 verse 2.
Iyan ni ori keta ese ikeji.
For in many things we offend all.
Nitori ninu on popo ni gbogbo wa nsi ise.
Again, he's talking about humanity in general, in humanity in general, society in general, people in general. In many things, people offend all.
O tun so ni gaga bi ede eniyan lati ma so asopo gbogbo eniyan ninu gbolo yi pe ninu on popo oni gbogbo wa nsi ise.
And he's telling us that if you really want to know the depravity of man, that man has fallen, that man is rotting, listen to the language of his mouth.
O si nso fun wa pe ta ba fe mo pe eniyan ti di baje eniyan ti subu sinu ese iwa fe ti si gbolo to ntenu eniyan jade.
Actually, if you look at the Bible, Old Testament and New Testament, there are many sins, many iniquities and transgressions and evil things that are attributed to the tongues of men.
Ti o ba wo nu bibeli nu majemu lailai tabi nu majemu titun wa ri pe opolopo awon ese ele ti opolopo awon eniyan da o lo je pe nipa soro enu won ni.
You are familiar with Romans chapter 3. What's the central message in Romans chapter 3? All have sinned and come short of the glory of God. What's the central message of Romans chapter
3?
There is none righteous, no, not one. What's the central message of Romans chapter
3?
That the whole world may become guilty in the sight of God. And so, Romans chapter 3 is talking about the depravity of man, the sinfulness of man, the universality of sin in human nature.
And
what is the proof that all have sinned? What is the proof that the world has become guilty before God? What is the proof that there is none righteous, no, not one? The proof is in the tongue of man. Look at it, Romans chapter 3, reading from verse 10. As it is written, there is none righteous, no, not one. There is none that understandeth, there is none that seeketh after God. They are all gone out of the way. They are all together become unprofitable. There is none that doeth good, no, not one. Universality of sin. The depravity of man. The fact that no man is righteous by himself. How do we know? How do we know that's the truth? Look at the proof. It's in verse 13. Their throat is an open sepulchre. With their tongue they have used deceit. The poison of herbs is under their lips, whose mouth is full of cursing and bitterness. Then he begins to list all the other sins that people commit.
He's
telling us that man is depraved, man is fallen, man is a sinner. How do you know he's a sinner? Listen to the language of his mouth.
Psalm 58 verse 3.
The wicked are estranged from the womb. That is, the wicked people, they are born sinners. They are sinners by nature. And then they are sinners by practice. That's depravity. All have sinned and come short of the glory of God. And sin is universal. How do you know? He says, look at his tongue. Look at at it, it says they go astray as soon as they be born speaking lies.
They're
telling us that the fountain will issue for the dirty water. The root will bear the branch, and the branch will produce the fruit. And if the fruit is bitter, don't blame the fruit. The problem is in the root. In Matthew chapter 12, here Jesus Christ himself tells us very pointedly and clearly, reading from verse 33, either make the tree good and its fruit good, or make the tree corrupt and its fruit corrupt. Man is depraved. How do you know that depravity of man? You see, the fruit is corrupt. It shows you that the root, the heart, the source, the fountain is corrupt and dirty. Look at verse 34. Generation of vine. Vipers. That's the nature, that's the source, that's the fountain, that's the hidden thing. Generation of vipers having poison within. How can you being evil in your nature, being evil in the heart, being evil in depravity, how can you being evil speak good things? Good things cannot come out of your tongue because the source is evil, the language will be
evil.
For out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh.
He's
telling us the bitter taste of the fruit of the tongue is derived from the root in the heart. Man is falling, therefore his speech is rotting. And among the things that indicate the universal depravity of man is the tongue of man. And that's why people offend. And if you live with somebody, if he doesn't offend you in other ways, you'll find if he's not genuinely born again, and even if he says he's born again, if he's not standing straight and standing firm in the Lord, the first way, the first area he will offend you is through his tongue. In fact, the Bible is very clear concerning the catalog of sins, of evil, of transgression of the tongue. In the Bible, we read of a wicked tongue. There is a deceitful tongue. There is even a lying tongue. There is a false tongue. There's a perverse tongue. The Bible talks of a froward tongue. There is a filthy, dirty, polluted, corrupt tongue. There is a naughty, rebellious, stubborn tongue. There is a bitter tongue. Even an angry tongue. A crafty, cunning, clever tongue. There is a flattering tongue. A slanderous tongue too. The Bible talks of a foolish tongue. How about a gossiping tongue? How about a backbiting tongue? How about a boasting tongue? In fact, a blaspheming tongue. There is a murmuring tongue too, and a cursing tongue, and a contentious tongue, a vile tongue. As you look at your tongue, and you look at all these lists, and you begin to examine one by one by one, and you see the kind of tongue you have, then it shows the kind of heart you have. In fact, the way the Lord has created us should show you there's a problem with the tongue. He put the tongue in a cage behind your teeth. And as if the cage is not enough, he walled it round with your mouth. Jesus' real problem with the tongue, and you have to cage that tongue so that it doesn't get loose. And even with the cage and with the walled in mouth, you see the problem is still there. And many, many times the tongues of people will just run loose and then transgress and disobey the Lord and sin against the Lord.
Nítorí ewu àti ipò ewu tí àwọn wà ìdí gan ni tí Ọlọ́run fi ṣe gbogbo àwọn ètò yìí ṣùgbọ́n pẹ̀lú gbogbo ètò tí Ọlọ́run ṣe nípa pé ó fi pamọ́ sínú àgò ó tún fi ètè ó tún fi ṣe ògiri yìí ká síbẹ̀ ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ àwọn ènìyàn ni àwọn wọn sì ń tì wọ́n lọ́gbọ̀ngbọ̀n
ṣubú. Have you noticed how your tongue has got you into trouble?
Ìwọ náà ti kíyèsí bí àwọn rẹ ṣe kó ọ sínú wàhálà.
Have you noticed how your tongue has not made you to be able to keep that salvation experience you say you have?
Ó wá ti kíyèsí bí àwọn rẹ ò ṣe fún ọ láǹfààní láti pa ìgbàlà tó jẹ́wọ́
pé o ní mọ́. Jude reading from verse 13.
Nínú Júdà ní ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹtàlá.
It says there are raging waves of the sea. It says there are fountain.
Ó ní omi òkun tí ń rú tí ń hó ìfófó ìtújú
rẹ̀. It says they are foaming out their own shame.
Ó ní wọ́n rú
because they're wandering stars.
Wọ́n jẹ́ ìràwọ̀ aláìní.
And then it says and they are foaming out their own shame, that's their tongue, foaming out their shame and talking of those evil things and dirty things. It says the blackness of darkness is reserved for them forever.
Ó ní tí wọ́n ìfófó ìtìjú ara wọn jáde ìyẹn ní nípa ahọ́n wọn. Ó ní wọ́n sọ nípa ìdájọ́ tí ó tẹ̀lé pé apá òkùnkùn bírí bí mọ́dé wọn sí láyé.
Verse 15 tells us that the Lord will be coming to execute judgment upon those people.
Ní ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹẹ̀ẹ́dógún ọ̀rọ̀ Ọlọ́run sọ pé Ọlọ́run ń bọ̀ láti wá ṣe ìdájọ́
lórí àwọn ènìyàn bẹ́ẹ̀. Judgment upon all.
Yóò ṣe ìdájọ́ lórí gbogbo ènìyàn.
And to convince all that are ungodly among them of all their ungodly deeds which they have ungodly committed.
Láti dá gbogbo àwọn aláìwà bí Ọlọ́run lẹ́bi ní ti gbogbo ìwà iṣẹ́ àìwà bí Ọlọ́run wọn.
And then he says of all their hard speeches which ungodly sinners have spoken against him.
Ó ní àti ní ti gbogbo ọ̀rọ̀ líle tí àwọn ẹlẹ́ṣẹ̀ aláìwà bí
Look at the manifestation of the sin in verse 16. They are murmurers. They are complainers. They are walking after their own lust. Their mouth speaketh great swelling words. Having men's persons in admiration because of advantage. How do you see yourself in all these verses we're looking at?
Báwo lo ṣe wá rí ara rẹ nínú àwòjí ìjìun tí à ń wò ní ọ̀rọ̀ Ọlọ́run yìí?
Do you murmur?
Ǹjẹ́ o máa ń kùn?
Do you complain?
Ṣé o já aláròye?
Do you speak those empty, boasting, bubbling words?
Ǹjẹ́ àwọn ọ̀rọ̀ ìfọ́nú, àwọn ọ̀rọ̀ kọ̀ǹgbẹ̀kọ̀ǹgbẹ̀ tẹnu rẹ jáde?
Swelling words of vanity.
Àwọn ọ̀rọ̀ ìhàlẹ̀ asán.
What surprise?
Àwọn ọ̀rọ̀ ìgbéraga.
What hypocrisy?
Àwọn ọ̀rọ̀
agbègbè. What insincerity?
Àwọn ọ̀rọ̀ ìjòyè
ọ̀tọ̀. Words that show that your heart is not transformed. Your heart is not taught. Your heart has not really fully experienced the grace of the Lord yet.
Àwọn ọ̀rọ̀ tó ń ṣàkóbá ìgbésí ayé rẹ pé o ò tí ì tọ orí ọ̀fẹ́ Ọlọ́run wò.
We come to point number 3 now.
A wá lọ sí kókó kẹta báyìí.
The declaration of our redemption through the tongue.
Ìjẹ́wọ́ ìràpadà wa nípasẹ̀ ahọ́n.
Here James is telling us something very important in chapter 3 verse 2.
Ní Jacob ti ń sọ ohun tó ṣe pàtàkì fún wa lórí kẹta ẹsẹ̀
ìkejì. He says, if any man offend not in word, the same is a perfect man, able also to bridle, to control, to check the whole body.
Ó ní bí ẹnìkan kò bá sì ṣiṣẹ́ nínú ọ̀rọ̀, òun náà ni ẹni pípé, òun ni ó sì lè kó gbogbo ara rẹ̀ níjàánu.
How do we know a righteous man? Listen to his language. How do we know a matured Christian? Listen to his speech. How do we know the one that has got the grace of God and the grace of God, the transforming power of God in his life, has perfected him? Listen to his language. How do you know a Christian husband? A Christian father in the home? A Christian member of the church. You cannot follow them all about. You don't know the secret sins people commit. But you don't need to know. Once they are defeated, once they are not living right in the language of their mouth, you know that in other areas they are failing to check up their language. If any man does not offend in word, that's a perfect man, that's a righteous man, that's a man that is walking with God.
àwọn ìgbà tá ò lè máa tẹ̀lé wọn káàkiri láti lè máa mọ irú àwọn nǹkan tí wọ́n ń wù níwà ní kọ̀rọ̀ àti ní gbangba ìwọ kíyèsí ọ̀rọ̀ tó bá ń tẹnu irú ẹni bẹ́ẹ̀ jáde nípasẹ̀ ọ̀rọ̀ rẹ̀ olótìmọ̀ bóyá kírísítẹ́nì tó ti fìdí rẹmi ni tàbí tó ń tẹ̀síwájú.
In James chapter 3 verse 13.
Nínú Jákọ́bù oríkẹta ẹsẹ̀.
Who is a wise man and endued with knowledge among you?
Ta ni ọgbọ́n tí ó sì ní ìmọ̀ nínú yín?
I'm a child of God.
Ọmọ Ọlọ́run ni mí.
I'm matured in the Lord.
Mo dàgbà nínú
Olúwa. I've been in the church for a long time.
Mo ti wà nínú ìjọ fún
ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ ọdún. And I'm really standing as a believer.
Mo sì ń dúró gbẹngbẹng gẹ́gẹ́ bí onígbàgbọ́.
If you don't know my value, I know my value. I am spiritual.
Sí ẹ̀ bá mọ bí mo ṣe tó ń pa ti ẹ̀mí, mo mọ bí mo ṣe tó ń pa
tí mo dàgbà. Ah, he's asking us a question.
Ó ń béèrè ìbéèrè
lọ́wọ́ rẹ̀. Who is that man in the church? Who is that woman in the church?
Ó ní ta lọkùnrin náà, ta lóbìnrin náà nínú ìjọ.
That says he's endued with knowledge.
Tó sọ pé òun gbọ́, òun sì ní ìmọ̀.
That he's matured and he's wise.
Tó sọ pé òun dàgbà, òun sì gbọ́n.
Look at that verse 13. Let him show out of a good conversation his work with meekness of wisdom.
Ìwọ wo ní ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹtàlá yẹn, ó ní ẹjẹ́ kí ó fi iṣẹ́ rẹ̀ hàn nípa ìwà rere, nípa ìwà tútù àti ọgbọ́n.
You don't have to talk too much that you are spiritual. When we listen to you, when we listen to your conversation, your language will prove to us whether you are shallow or you are deeper, whether you are carnal or you are spiritual.
Ó nílò láti ṣẹ̀ṣẹ̀ máa gbélé ǹga irú ẹni tó jẹ́ fún wa pé báyìí ni mo jẹ́, báyìí ni mo jẹ́, ńgbà bá fetí sí ọ̀rọ̀ ẹnu rẹ̀, òun láfimọ̀ bóyá ẹni tó jẹ́ pé olófege ni ọ́ tàbí owalẹ̀ jìn, tàbí láfimọ̀ bóyá o jẹ́ ojúlówó tàbí ayédèrú.
In Ephesians chapter 4.
Nínú Éfésù orí kẹrin.
Verse 21.
Ẹsẹ̀ ìkọkànlélógún.
If so be that ye have heard him and have been taught by him as the truth is in Jesus.
Pípé tó wá ṣe pé nítòótọ́ ni ẹ̀yin ti gbọ́ ohun rẹ̀ tí a sì kọ́ yín nínú rẹ̀ ní gẹ́gẹ́ bí òtítọ́ ti ń bẹ nínú Jésù.
How do we show that we have known the Lord?
Báwo la sì sọ ipa ọmọ Olúwa?
That the Lord Jesus is living inside us.
Wípé Kristi ìfinú wa ṣe ibùgbé.
That we have fellowship with him, he has fellowship with us.
Wípé a ní ìdàpọ̀ pẹ̀lú rẹ̀, ó ní ìdàpọ̀ pẹ̀lú wa.
That he is teaching us and we are following after his footsteps.
Wípé ó ń kọ́ wa, a sì ń tọ ipasẹ̀ rẹ̀.
Verse 22, that she put off concerning the former conversation the old man.
Ní oríkẹrin ẹsẹ̀ ìkejìlélógún pé ní ti ìwà yín àtijọ́ kí
which is corrupt according to deceitful laws. That is all the conversation of the old life, all the language of the old life, all the jokes of the old life. When you get rid of them and we don't see the old man in your speech, in your language, in your behavior, then we know you have known the Lord. Then we know you are in fellowship with the Lord.
Ìyẹn ni pé gbogbo àwọn ọ̀rọ̀ àtijọ́ ti máa ń tẹnu wa jáde nígbà tá àti ìdẹni ìgbàlà. Gbogbo irú àwọn nǹkan bẹ́ẹ̀ yẹn láti kọ́ tì. Gbogbo àwọn àwàdà akọ, gbogbo àwọn ìṣẹ̀fẹ̀ àti yẹ̀yẹ́, gbogbo rẹ̀ láti yí kọ́kọ́ tì kí a bàa lè mẹ̀ pé nítòótọ́ láti wà nínú
Olúwa. And be renewed in the spirit of your mind.
Kí ẹ sì di titun nínú ẹ̀mí inú
yín. Remember, if the spirit of your mind is renewed, it will affect your tongue. Once your heart is touched and transformed and set on fire by the fire of the Holy Ghost, it will come out in your tongue. A righteous heart, a righteous tongue. A spiritual heart, a spiritual tongue. A heart that is having the grace of God, a gracious tongue.
Ó jẹ́ mọ̀ wípé nígbàtí iṣẹ́ orí ọ̀fẹ́ bá ṣẹlẹ̀ nínú ọkàn wa, èyí yóò jẹ́ jáde nínú ọ̀rọ̀ tí ó máa tẹnu wa jáde, torí pé ọkàn wa yóò jẹ́ mímọ́, bẹ́ẹ̀ ni ọ̀rọ̀ ẹnu wa náà yóò jẹ́ mímọ́. Ipò tí ọkàn wa wà nípa ti ẹ̀mí yóò fi hàn pé a jẹ́ ẹni tẹ̀mí nípa ti
ẹ̀mí. Wherefore, in verse 25, put away lying.
Ní ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹẹ̀dọ́gbọ̀n, nítorí náà ẹ fi èké ṣíṣe sílẹ̀.
Put away exaggeration.
Ẹ mú ọ̀rọ̀ àsọríkè kúrò.
Put away flattery.
Ẹ mú ọ̀rọ̀ ìfọnu kúrò.
And put away deceit.
Ẹ mú ẹ̀tàn kúrò.
And put away flattery.
Ẹ mú ọ̀rọ̀ pé ká máa fọnu kúrò.
And put away something adding to the story, something you know is not there telling a lie. Put away all those lines.
Ká mú gbogbo àwọn nǹkan tí ò bá sojú wa tá a fi ń kún ọ̀rọ̀, ká mú gbogbo ẹ̀ kúrò.
And speak every man truth with his neighbor.
Kí olúkúlùkù yín kí ó máa bá ọmọ nìkejì.
Isn't that the evidence that we have met the one that said, I'm the way, I'm the truth, I'm the life? When you have met that truth, and you know that truth, and that truth has set you free, you will speak truth with your neighbor.
Eléwà kí wá ṣe àmì wípé a ti bẹ́ ẹni tó sọ pé èmi ni ọ̀nà òtítọ́ àti ìyèpàdé. Ìyẹn ni pé nígbà tí òtítọ́ rẹ̀ bá ń gbénu wa, yóò ràn wá lọ́wọ́ láti máa sọ òtítọ́ jáde.
In verse 29, let no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth.
Ní ẹsẹ̀ ìkọkàndínlọ́gbọ̀n, ẹ má ṣe jẹ́ kí ọ̀rọ̀ ìdìbàjẹ́ kan ti ẹnu yín
jáde. Abusive language, let no corrupt communication come out of your mouth.
Ọ̀rọ̀ èbú má ṣe jẹ́ kí ọ̀rọ̀ ìdìbàjẹ́ kan ti ẹnu rẹ jáde.
The tail bearing in the barber shop, let let no corrupt communication come out of your mouth.
Kama sofofo nle nigba jama bi ati ngeru ma je je ki oro eti di ba je
ta conversation concerning men, concerning women, that will bring immorality, that's talking about immorality, joking with sin. Let no corrupt communication come out of your mouth.
Gbogbo awon oro idoti awon oro rirun e to ma mu yan ronu pa ife ku fe ati iwa ese ma se je ki oro idi ba je kan
tenu re ja. Let the language of Zion. Let it be the language of grace. Let it be the language of Christ. Whatever Christ will not say, whatever we cannot hear from Christ, a joke, a word, a language we cannot hear from Christ, if you are a Christian, it will not come out of your mouth. Let no corrupt communication come out of your mouth.
But
that which is good, your word will do good in other people's lives. When your heart is good, your heart is pure, your intention is good, and you want to be a blessing to another person, and you wake up in the morning, you make a covenant with the Lord, nothing bad, nothing evil, nothing injurious, nothing destructive will come out of my mouth today, only that which is good, edifying and profitable. Which is good to the use of edifying. To edify means you are teaching other people, counseling other people, building up other people, encouraging other people. They will not hear word from your mouth and they feel like going and dying. They will not hear a word from your mouth and say, well, if I'm going to backslide, let me backslide. But what's that bill? What's that care? What's that comfort? What's that help other people to want to move forward? That it may minister grace to the hearers. That is going to take place. There should be absolute control over our mouth. In 1 Corinthians chapter 9 verse 27. But I keep my body under. Before I go on, can I remind you, if a man can put his tongue under control, his whole body will be under control. You cannot control your body if you cannot control your tongue. I keep my body under. The first thing to do, therefore, is to keep your tongue under. And I bring it to subjection. Let's that by any means, when I preach to others, I myself should be a castaway. The Lord has challenged us today. He has told us to reconsider our lives, reconsider our calling, reconsider our behavior, reconsider our testimony, and see whether the profession we have is biblically based or we're only deceiving ourselves. My brethren, therefore, be not many masters. Before you rush out to counsel other people, counsel yourself. Before you correct them, correct yourself. Before you preach to them, preach to yourself. Before you set them right, set yourself right. Otherwise, knowing that we shall receive the greater condemnation. For in many things we offend all. If you don't lay that tongue upon the altar when you wake up in the morning, from that morning till evening, in the office, in the bus, everywhere, you'll be offending everybody, slashing, criticizing, destroying people. You'll be offending everybody you meet on the way with your tongue. But if any man offend not in word, a glorious day, wonderful day, that you look at every hour and every moment and say, praise the Lord, my tongue was under the grace of God, under the control of the Lord. I didn't deliberately offend anybody with my tongue today. It was so gracious, it was so wonderful. You come back to the Lord, you thank the Lord. When you wake up the following day, you say, Lord, repeat the same victory today, O Lord, and let me be kind and gracious in my language.
alẹ loni mi o ri bi kan ti mo ti pa enikeni lara tori na olorun to fun mi lori ofe nijo keji to tun so fo olorun pe ko tun tun ohun yi se nu aye re yo je agbayanu.
I want to tell the Lord to help me in my tongue.
Mo fe so fun Oluwa pe ko ran mi lowo.
I want to tell the Lord to control this my tongue.
Mo fe so fun Olorun pe ko Olorun ko
gba. I want to tell the Lord to put his fire from heaven on this my tongue.
Mo fe gbadura si Oluwa ko ko ran ina orun sinu ahun.
I want to tell the Lord to remove carelessness from me in my speaking.
Mo fe so fun Olorun pe ko Olorun ko mu iwa ijafara kuro nu ahun.
I want to tell the Lord to give me the words of Jesus.
Mo fe ki Olorun ko fun mi
the kindness of Jesus. The love of Jesus. I want the Holy Spirit to control my tongue.
Mo fe ki emi mo Olorun ko gba
esoko sa. The way I speak to my members of my family.
Ona ti won ma fi
gba ba speak to members in our church. The way I speak to fellow workers in our church. The way I talk to the unbelievers. I want my tongue to announce that I'm a child of God. I want my language to show people from the morning till evening that my language will show that my heart has been transformed by the grace of God. Why don't you rise up and tell the Lord? Tell the Lord, my tongue has always been getting me into trouble. My tongue has always been making me to go astray. My tongue has been disproving my testimony. My tongue has been contradicting the doctrine I believe. Lord, bring me back to Calvary and nail this tongue on the cross of Calvary so that this tongue will not lead me astray, will not lead me to hell. Pray and the Lord will give you grace. Pray and the Lord will give you grace.
We'll
put your tongue under control. And your tongue will be a blessing. It will not be a curse. Your tongue will gather together with Christ. It will not scatter from Christ.